In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make a smooth sliding transition inside of Premiere Pro. My name is Vegard and I do weekly Premiere Pro and filmmaking tutorials, so make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out on future videos. I got two clips on the timeline and I really want to transition from this clip right here and into the next clip with it sliding this way. So the first thing we need to do is to drag this first clip that we are transitioning from up to video track number 2. And then you can select how long you want the transition to be. So I really want to start around here, I think. And then I can drag the second clip that we are going to transition to under the first clip. So now we have these two clips stacked together. And then I'm going to select the eraser tool by hitting C on my keyboard. And I'm going to make a cut right here at the first clip. And I'm also going to make a second cut at the second clip. So now we have sectioned off these two clips right here. Then we can go and select the first clip that we are transitioning from. And we're going to work inside of effect controls. So I'm going to put my playhead at the beginning of the clip. And I'm going to make a keyframe. So I'm going to make a keyframe for position. And I'm going to go forward in the clip and make another keyframe. So I'm just going to drag this to the side, and I just want this clip to be slightly off to the side right here, just so we don't see it anymore. Then I'm going to drag this last keyframe all the way to the end of the clip. So now it will look something like that. This looks a little bit weird, so we are going to make this other clip slide at the same speed as the first clip. So first we need to hide this first clip. And we can hide this video track number 2 by clicking the toggle track output, and then it disappears. Then we can select the second clip, and we're going to make some keyframes on this clip as well. So let's move the playhead to the beginning of the clip, and then we're going to toggle a keyframe, and we're just going to drag this all the way to the other side, so we are slightly off screen. Then I'm going to move my playhead to almost the end of the clip again, and I'm going to drag this until we have it in the same place that it should be. And then I'm going to drag this last keyframe at there as well. I'm also going to add some blur, but let's see how it looks. So now we just have this simple little slide transition, but I'm going to add some blur. So the first thing we need to do is to go down here and select New Adjustment Layer. And when you get this box here, you just click OK. And inside of the project bin, we have this adjustment layer. So I'm just going to drag this on top of both of the clips. And I'm just going to trim it so it fits on the transition right here. And then we're going to search for an effect right here called the Directional Blur. And you will find that in the video effects, blur and sharpen folder, and you have the directional blur right here. So let's drag that on top of our adjustment layer. And then I'm going to go to the beginning of the clip right here. And I'm going to set the values in the directional blur to 90 degrees. So that is horizontal. And then we can increase the blur, and this is something you can decide how much blur or not you want, but I think I'm going to go around 30. And if you play this back right now, this is how it looks. But if this is too slow for you, I will show you how you can make this go faster. So to make this go faster, we can simply select all of the clips that are in this slide transition section, and we can right click and nest it. So click the nest button right there and click OK. And then we can go over here and use the rate stretch tool, or you can just click R on your keyboard. And this will allow you to adjust how fast this section of the transition will be. So let's say I want to make this double as fast. I could just drag this, and then we can put this first clip on there, and make sure we delete this. And when we play this back right now, we got a faster transition. On the screen right now, we got another video for you to watch next. And if you haven't yet, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. Thank you so much for watching Create and Inspire, and I will see you in the next video.